Well, project time again. Doing something I haven't done in a long time. Decided I'd break down another Night Finder. Two, actually. Kind of from the Goodwill. It's missing its air restrictor. The point where I'm finding modded blasters. God. Oh, yeah. I love it when I find things like this. Spiders. Oh, it's a dead one. Thing is filthy. God. Left out in the sun forever, too, apparently. Triggers all the wrong color. All around it. You see that ring? Being left out and baked. Oh. Jeez. Well, hopefully it's still going to be worthwhile using. I ain't got many of these left. Yeah, another expense that we go through that proves almost utterly useless. A large box of O-rings. Yes, for $24.99 you can pick up this large box of O-rings from Harbor Freight and never use ones such as this. Unless you're in the circus. And then it's a circus ring, which probably shouldn't have said on camera, but heck, it's not exactly the same as an O-ring. Well, I guess a circus ring is kind of an O-ring. Just the O. Different kind of O. Oh, one of these ought to fit a Night Finder. What the hell am I ever going to use these tiny little shits for? I mean, lots of tiny, tiny little O-rings. All their wonderful size charts that will equate to nothing. All I gotta do is find one over the plunger tube and then break down the other Night Finder. I'm working on an old project. Revamping it. Back to work. One of the things I hate about taking out air restrictors is sometimes you'll wind up with this crap. It's the part of it inside. When you drill through it, leaves this ring. Doesn't really affect anything as far as modding goes, because the whole thing's out. But it leaves this noise. It's really annoying. Oh, these stupid tabs go through clean, which I don't normally go with like this anyways. Damn it. I have nothing. Oh, maybe this will work. I can cut these down with. Maybe this will do the trick. You get these. Just seems somewhat unfinished. I hate it. I don't like stuff being unfinished, and it's annoying as hell to have these things in here rattling around. If I can just get it to come loose, cut free, it wouldn't, I guess, be so bad. Well, we'll see what happens. Get the other one open. Much better looking on the in. Damn it. Always pays to have a nice big screwdriver laying around here on occasion. Because some of these stupid things are just on here so damn tight that there's no reason for it. I mean, damn it. Oh, someday those things are going to be the death of me. Stupid end strike rails. I don't even use them for anything. Well, this one is so torqued down that it snapped them. Whoever the kid was that decided to try to mod this thing before I got my hands on it really did a freaking number to it. screw holes are stripped. Springs are shot up. Took out the entire buffer thing. Every bit of it. On the inside. God knows what that thing's been pounding up against on in here. Yeah, there's bits of wear all over this. I'm gonna have to clean that up. I was wondering, though, if anybody here is even taking apart a Night Finder. What the hell do you guys do? Or even the Fire Strikes, for that matter. What the hell do you guys do with these things? The lights, I mean, it's got a shitty little switch in here, which won't hold much amperage. And I better move this to the screw on the bottom before I lose it. Those little tiny flat nuts here cause me so much bane. Forget about the damn things. I'd lose it. Couldn't figure out why my Night Finder wasn't going back together. Damn it, Hasbro. I got like 8 of these stupid light assemblies just sitting around. Probably even more than that. Can't really bring myself to throw them out for some reason. I mean, they really don't serve a purpose. I mean, it's not even a decent light. I mean, at least the Fire Strikes are, like, kind of cool. I mean, this thing's just awkward. It just doesn't even fit one here well. It's all kinds of weird. Ah, well. You guys figured out a use for the things. Besides gathering piles of dust. Let me know in the comment box. Back to work. I'm not sure if you guys can hear this or not. But it is one of the joys of living in a trailer. Is there is no such thing as a sound buffer anywhere. And I have... I'm going nuts. The wind outside is blowing this thing like the beer can it is. The entire thing is shaking. I can hear it buckling and popping and just doing all kinds of horrible, horrible sounds. It is utterly terrifying. And I grew up in a trailer with woodpecker. Oh God, woodpeckers are the worst. Just like little tiny jab hammers of dumb dick. Because they're so stupid, they think they're going to get through to get the bugs. But no, you dumbass bird, it's metal. Unless you got an adamantium beak or something, you ain't getting in. Stupid birds. It's almost as annoying as... This wind is killing me. The wind is killing me. If it blows any harder, I'm going to have a hard time making my cuts straight. Jesus. Ugh. Joys of living in a trailer. They never stop. Back to work. Clean up my work. Trying to polish the Night Finder tubes down. So I have something a bit smoother. I was thinking of couplering them to take... what is it? Half inch PVC. But I'm not. It's pretty much meant for stock darts anyways. At least I think that's what this is mostly used for. Or will be used for. Since I'm decided I'm not keeping this. It's best to go with whatever you can surmise. I still could... I guess everyone making sleeper breeches now. Go in and Add a bunch of brass. If I feel like buying brass. Ugh. And slide it down in there. I'm not gonna paint it. It needs to be that nice rough look. Just gonna sand it up the best I can so it winds up looking like this. A little better light there. There we go. Adjust my viewfinder. Yep, there it is. So it looks more like this. It cleaned up pretty good. Never happy with my own work. Still gotta do the shell. And get all this crap off of here. Just files, people. Files. Oh, that and emery boards. Oh, man. I love emery boards. Things are awesome. Looks so good. Forgetting all those pain in the ass logos and warning labels off. So much better. Less scarring. Lifting up your blaster. If you're a freak like me, you gotta have that shit cleaned up. It's gotta be clean. Those memory boards will save you a lot of work on your hands as well, because they're already sandy. They'll make a good... Well, I exactly know what the grit is. I mean, I buy the two-sided ones. I like the spongy ones when I can find them. Oops. There's a spot to fix. They're kind of hard to get, and they're kind of expensive. So I usually wind up getting the wooden ones. Are just cheap. And yes, occasionally I do use them on my fingers, my nails. That's what they are for. But for the most part, memory boards are just awesome. They can get into all kinds of little places that you normally couldn't get. I mean, even with some of the files I got that are a good size, or rather narrow, some of them don't even get into spots I need to. You can just take an emery board and splinter it down. It'll go right in. Alright. Commercial breaks over here. Archer's back on. I want to hear what he's talking about. Archer's awesome. That moment when your only replacement cat spring goes shooting across your shop, bounces off two random walls and follows behind stuff, and you dig it out only to watch it roll down the vent. I hate you. This is where I wish I had the money to have a bandsaw. At least had my damn sander set up. Any space in here. Make everything so much freaking easier. There should be a law. One of the things I wish I could have had some money to do, which would be totally awesome, it'll never work in my area, is those free workspaces. People just kind of do their stuff. They come in and they work. You know, with all the tools readily available. These things are awesome. You'll never find them in my area. This is the area where it goes to die. And nothing would ever work. It would be destroyed. stolen. Everything will be ripped off. God forbid we have nice things. Not in Harrisburg. Nope. Ghetto capital of Pennsylvania. If you don't believe me, look at a map. Make life so much easier. But I guess all I really have to do is wait for that YouTube's money. Huh? That's what we're all doing, right? We're all just waiting for the YouTube's money. Nah, that looks pretty flat. Alright, do the other one and clean her up. I'm trying to remember how the hell I did this in the first place. I don't think I had any connection points back here like this. I think this was all... The putty's starting to get warm. It's starting to set. I'm still moving it around. Which isn't good. Lord. Perfectionism is not a thing to achieve or aspire for. Neither is good enough. There's a layer in between that needs to be your aim, like a sliding scale. That's what you need to shoot for. Less than perfect, but better than a failure. This doesn't sound very good for advice, but if you shoot for solid perfection constantly, you'll expect it, and there'll be nothing but failure. Or see only flaws. More deep thoughts while modding. The only one that concerns me is this crap gonna hold together? When I flip it over. We shall see. And now we play the waiting game as the putty dries. Hoping these stay square. Sometimes this putty shrinks. And you can see I got two different types. Let's go in here. One is really good stuff my buddy Beaker gave me. The other is, I think, either the JB Weld or it's the leftovers of the, which is most likely because it came out of the tube, big tube of my marine stuff, which is really, really tacky, but it doesn't dry quickly and it dries gummy. It takes a while to harden out. As long as it stays intact and well enough to file, it'll be all right. Then I gotta get the front working and get that jointed up and together, which I maybe should have done first. Oh well. You learn. And this is nothing like I built the first one. So, hopefully, these will turn out a little bit better. And I'm gonna wrap the handle anyways on it. So, comfort. I'm not putting the bar in. It's gonna be a little tighter. I got to get the trigger set across the center, so I don't know if I actually want to cut something out of plastic or just use the old hanger again. Just cutting plastic is kind of a pain in the ass. Never get the edge straight enough. Oh well. Back to work.
While these things continue to cure and dry, I'm going on to the next step of the process. I had to cut actually quite a bit off the sides because they were going to be a lot wider and it looked really bad. So we're going with this. Hopefully this will turn out okay.
Just start over. This is gonna be a mess. So I got my blade all done, and it's gonna require some sanding to get it to that nice edge, like right here, and then shaping. And in case you're wondering, no, I did not intend to make it diamond plated. That is the wrong side glued together to the right side. So now I have to take this off and put it together, and I did not realize that until I took a look at it just here. Great, thank you, camera view. Damn it. Well, whatever. Trials and tribulations of modding. If it was easy, everybody would do it. Oh, wait, we do. Haha. Back to a long night of work. Well, no, because I got work tomorrow. A little bit of this and some beer. So, I think I've gotten a pretty good blade here. It's not absolutely perfect, but I'm going for a middle of a hammered look. Just real easy to accomplish when you kind of don't know what you're doing. One of the steps is now, is you got to seal it. You can do it with a heat gun, but I find that a lighter works so much better. The only downside is that you got to keep, it's kind of hard to do while you're trying to pay attention to a camera at the same freaking time. But you got to move it along. And you take up all the little furry edges. It seals it up really nice. It can save you a lot of time on the backside of doing these things. And I'm not completely done with shaping it. I just wanted to get some cleanup done on here. And if you're really good, or you're brave enough to try it, you can actually try to fix some of your mistakes this way, but I wouldn't recommend it. The next step is to basically smack it with a sandpaper. And I'd love to film all of this while I'm doing it, but you kind of can't. And I don't want to get all this crap up in my camera, so I'm only going to do a little here. See, now it makes, since I'm going for a kind of rough look, I don't got to worry too much. About the final finish. But you still want to sand it off as much as you can. And it's back to this again. With the lighter. Clean up the edges. Hopefully. Riveting television, I'm sure. But we got a decent edge. Not completely atrocious. A little straightening up, and hopefully it'll turn out better. Yeah, see, get my war paint going here. All that black fur. Yeah. Back to work. Well, hopefully that'll work. Not perfect, but it's foam. Yeah, I gotta fix that right there. There's my sticks right here. Really got to be careful of how far I go up, how far I go into it. All right. Now, get this thing fit together. And hopefully it'll work. I think so much problems could be avoided in this stuff, like when you're doing things, is just patience. None of us have any patience. We really want to get these things together, and taking the time to do it right, it just doesn't happen often. Lots of noise, ain't it? I'm not talking things like I'm just rushing in. I mean, like test fitting and things like that. We don't really do enough of. I can't hardly talk. Stress the fact enough that test fitting is absolutely awesome. See, it won't quite go where I want it. It means I gotta open it up more. Oh, let's see how much longer my voice holds out. Maybe I'll just get a video to these and no more audio for a little bit. Well, that was almost bad. One of the original problems with this mod was that it wasn't serviceable once it was placed together. There was no way to open her back up and get to the insides because the coupler on the front was retaining all of the stuff. So I started putting this thing together, and I had forgotten all about that little fact, and damn near glued the coupler in without having any of the internals in place, which, at the very least, would have been a problem, because I wouldn't have a way to get the damn thing open to get all the parts back out. And that would be that would have been a big damn issue. Right now I got glue all over this damn coupler on both sides of it. The only solution I could come up with that would do this cleanly enough is basically I'm just gluing it in one side. I mean, that's not what I want to do. I'd rather have a pin system or something else, because I don't ever really trust these adhesives to hold everything down like I need it to. I trust them to fail, which is a shame, because they're only glue. The trick is keeping it out of the screw ports in the bottom, keeping it straight and keeping it in place. It's turning out to be a bit of a bigger issue than I thought it was going to be. Need to mix up more glue. Anybody knows the name of a single glue that will hold itself together as well as this 3M stuff, let me know. I would much appreciate it. Because all this stuff is really good. I need something that sets in this kind of time frame. There we go. Tricky part. Get glue inside here. So it spills out. Onto the parts I want. Not get it. On the coupler lip. Oh, the glue. Gluing. Hopefully, that'll work. Bear with me, because I'm losing my voice. I was worried about the stability of the shell here. And it's already starting to fall apart with this small amount of glue that I have. So in order to brace it, I've created plates out of random plastics. It's just something that they ship at Walmart. If you ever go to Walmart and you go back to the automotive section, they have these long cardboard boxes they put the towing trailer hitch balls in. Well, in the bottom of them to keep them from ripping through is this pretty heavy-duty plastic, and they come in long strips. I just save them because they make good random fillers. I'm not sure what kind of plastic it is. It does have a textured back on one side and quite smooth on the other. As you can see, it's rather shiny and then dull. We're going to see how this turns out. Ugh. God, I'm sick. More work. Well, even with just the one plate there, nothing on yet. Alright, that's this part of the shell. That's really solid. Yeah, it's gonna work out good. All I gotta do is put on three more and cut a hole for the blade. Back to work. Starting over. Still sick. Really didn't want to have to do this, but I got to. Drilled all those holes in the other one. And just didn't look as good as I wanted it to. Simplified like this is a little nicer. Uses less screws too. Plus I kind of missed all my markers where I want to really put the screws. Some of them didn't even get a hold of plastic. They're just there. If it had been different, I think it would have been something else. Probably wouldn't be redoing it. Well, it's a lie. It probably would be. It's gotta be right. We all know that. That's why we do this. Well, not really. It's just hard to formulate thoughts when you're sick. That didn't even... anything but sitting in my chair and just watching television, trying in vain to sleep between hacking coughs. At least the plates are done. Hopefully they'll fit. If not, I go back to the old ones. I really don't want to do that because I don't like the way they look. Just gotta remember what I gotta do the inside here. but I'm good. More work. So, as promised, here is the final shot of something I made once again. I decided to go with a bronze colored blade. Don't know why. It doesn't really match it. Just like the color of it. Wrapped the handle with some crap over here from Wilson's. Rip. It was on clearance at Walmart. So, there we go. I was on clearance. So, dig that. So, here's the overshot of the blade. Little different this time. Still an upgrade. I can prop it up here. There we go. Plating held out pretty cool. Hopefully it won't fly apart when we go to shoot it. The commissioner likes it. They don't know they're even getting it yet. If you like this kind of stuff, let me know. I'll keep making videos of me modding. I mean, that's pretty cool for me. I like putting my thoughts on there. If you don't, let me know in the sections down below and I'll stop. If you got any suggestions for videos, let me know. Either a thumbs up, a thumbs down, preferably a comment, and a little of both. Oh, man, I gotta get some sleep. I don't want to take another day off of work, but finally kicking the cold in the butt. Well, well. I guess I watch myself, huh? Sleep. That's creepy. All right, folks. Good night.